You think of this place? This
is
one.
Okay, go for it. Okay, good. The mixture is not flashing our new camera. And it does look very green. And if these are a total washout for the bar mitzvah, I think you're going to have a really good St. Patrick's Day item.
Fresh is up. There we go. Wait, he's got to get it here.
Oh, here comes the flour. You have insurance on that machine, don't you?
Oh, sure. We just had to have it fixed, as a matter of fact.
And your workman's comp is fully paid?
Thank God, yes. Okay, what he did was he took a regular water dough recipe and added your ingredients, mm-hmm. and we're going to see how it comes out.
What was in that? When we done the
liquid would have been malt syrup. What else has he got in there? Some he probably had the sugar and the salt all mixed together in the water, and then the yeast, of course, also was in there. So he's pretty much ready to go here. And this is the smallest dough we talked. This is the smallest dough that we make, which is 25 pounds of flour. The other mixer makes much larger doughs, but this little mixer we use for the smaller doughs.
Now, are there any bagels that require that the yeast be proofed, or is the yeast always included with the dry ingredients on bagels?
Always included with the dry ingredients, yeah. Actually, I think it goes in with the wet ingredients, the way he does it. He crumbles it into the malt syrup and a little water mixture. That's the way he does it.
He dampens it a little
bit. Correct. I think the main thing you have to watch with yeast is that you don't put yeast and salt together. Yeast and salt kind of have a problem. So we keep those two ingredients apart.
And the malt syrup is what activates the yeast, makes the yeast grow.
Yeah, right, the malt helps. The malt, you know, everybody in the bagel business uses similar ingredients. We tend to use malt syrup, but my father has always used that. It gives you a very different taste. If you don't go with there's a lot of sweeteners in bagels. We use sugar, we use dextrose, which is corn sweetener, and then we use the malt syrup. But the malt syrup gives the bagel a much richer taste, at least we think so. You taste other bagels, and that's what I think, one of the things that makes our bagel unique is the malt syrup. It's more expensive, but it also gives it a little different flavor.
Do you think most of the commercial bagels are made with corn syrup?
I don't think so. They use, there's always malt. In flour, there's malted barley, but the malt syrup gives you a little different flavor.
What do your competitors use to make the inferior bagels?
More sugar instead of the malt syrup. They're all sweeteners.
More like a corn syrup.
Right. This is pretty much done. I mean, you're done there.